Hello everyone, namaste. Welcome to my channel VPK Nutrition, Mind Body Healing with Pushpa. I'm Pushpa Soundarajan, registered dietitian, Ayurvedic practitioner and yoga teacher. Today we're going to be talking more about spices and how to use them as medicine. Stay tuned. Welcome back everyone. So in last week's episode, I talked about how to kindle the Agni if you have a weak Agni. Now, one of the things that I had mentioned was using spices as either as medicine or as in food to help you kindle that Agni or rev up that metabolism. Now, again, when we think of spices, usually we think of spices for flavor, because any cuisine you take in the world, they have some sort of spices. Some have unique spices, and every part of the world has different spices. And of course, Indian cooking is well known for all of its spices. Then of course, people talk about curry a lot. Again, curry is not just one spice. It's actually usually a blend of spices. Now, they're blended in such a proportion that they're actually very healthy for the body. It doesn't have some kind of, some random blending, but actually you can blend spices in such a way that they can be used medicinally for the different body types. And so today's episode, I'm going to talk about of course they are very pungent in nature. I'm going to talk about the medicinal properties of spices and how you can use them in your own daily life. So let's talk about the classification of spices. Now again, they have a lot of properties which I have discussed in the 6 taste video a few weeks ago. If you're interested, you can learn about that. But for the purpose of today's video, I'm going to just talk about two different classifications. One is based on its taste. Second one is based on its virya or potency, which is either cooling or heating in nature. So the first one is taste, which is called rasa or the essence of something. And of course, the second one is virya, potency, cooling or heating. So let's talk about taste first. So when you look at the taste of spices, it is usually pungent dominant in nature. So most spices, pretty much every one of them actually, are pungent in nature. However, there are some spices could have a little bit of sweet taste to them. They could have some bitter taste to them. And these things will give them more of a cooling virya. So in terms of the second category, which is virya or potency, they can be classified as heating spices or cooling spices. Some of them are very heating. Some of them can be anushna, which is like warming. So again, even there are classifications, but for the purpose of today's video, we're just going to stick to the heating spices and the cooling spices. First, let's start with the heating spices. So what are some examples of heating spices? Ginger, cayenne pepper, black pepper, cumin, ajwain, cinnamon, and also tulsi, cloves. These all can be very heating in nature. So what are the advantages of having a heating spice? First of all, heating spices help to kindle the weak Agni or Manda Agni. Usually a Kapha person or a person with a Kapha imbalance will have a Manda Agni, or it could be anybody really can have a weak Agni. Now, if you are one of those people who has a weak Agni, definitely use a lot of these heating spices either in cooking, or you can make teas with them, like I gave that example last week of making the CCF and fenugreek tea. So the second thing is, if you have a very tikshan Agni, very sharp Agni, like in a Pitta person, then what do? You don't eat too much of these heating spices, because these things can lead to a lot of acid problems, acid reflux and heartburn and things like that. So there you would still eat something like a ginger or a cumin or whatever, but not necessarily cayenne pepper, because that is ati ushna, very hot. So and also you can always add a few cooling spices to make it a little bit lesser for the tikshan Agni people. Now, as when it comes to a Vata person, now they also have erratic Agni or Visham Agni. We talked about this before. So when they have erratic or irregular digestion and they're hungry sometimes, now that also shows that their Agni is weak. It's not effectively working. So in those cases, they still need the heating spices, because they need that kindling of the Agni. But at the same time, too much hot, like the cayenne pepper and things like that, can cause drying in the body. So vatas are already dry in nature. So you don't want to dry them out even more, because that's just going to lead to more gas and bloating and constipation and those kinds of issues that vatas usually suffer from. So this is what it is about the heating spices. And I want you to remember, even if you're making a tea, then look at what kind of agni you have before you make that tea. Tea is hot infusion, is basically like making a decoction where you're just heating it, boiling it in water, and then steeping it and filtering and drinking. So let's talk about some cooling spices. So what are some of the examples? We can think of coriander, cardamom, cilantro, which is herbs. Then you can have fennel, fenugreek. Now fenugreek is methi seeds. Fenugreek is cooling because it is a combination of air and space dominance. It's a bitter herb. So bitter is always cooling in nature. So fenugreek will be cooling in nature. Turmeric, again, turmeric, we hear so much about turmeric and its benefits. It is a bitter spice, so bitter is always good for detoxifying the body. So bitter is also cooling in nature. So again, that is a cooling spice. And of course, mint is very cooling. So see, these are some of the cooling spices that we use in regular cooking. Now, when it comes to a pitta person who has a tikshna agni, or you know, anybody who's got an imbalanced agni, which is too sharp, then definitely these are the spices to go for. Now, you can also make something called a cold infusion or a hema with these kinds of things. So if you're suffering from hyperacidity or heartburn, I usually recommend that you add like a teaspoon of either a coriander or fennel in the water at night. You know, you can even put it in like a copper or a tumbler or a cup, and then soak it overnight and then drink it in the morning. So this will actually help you cool down the system inside and kind of reduce some of that pitta or heat in the body. The second thing is, of course, if you are, let's say you're a kapha person, then definitely you don't want a lot of cooling spices, but you still want to use some of these spices to balance the excess of heat that you're using when you're using the cayenne pepper and things like that. So that is very important to remember. Though the vata person, again, we don't want to cool them down too much, but definitely we want to balance it out, the cool and the heating spices. For example, in Indian cuisine, typically when we use coriander and cumin, they're like sister spices. So we always use like 2 or 3 times the amount of coriander to cumin ratio just to balance it out. So in any spice blends anybody makes, this is always a combination. We add more coriander, less of the cumin. So if you look at it, so all these spices have been so incorporated in Indian cuisine, but they've also talked about how the proportion should be. So we may not even know why that was done, why these recipes were made that way, but there is an Ayurvedic basis to this, because even in those days, they used spices as medicine. So these are some wonderful things to try out in your own cooking, and also pay attention to how these spices make you feel. How, you know, when you eat them, does it affect your stomach? If it helps your digestion? Some of them can be diuretics. Like example, cumin seeds are a diuretic. So when you make a tea with that, it actually helps you get rid of a lot of the fluids in the body. So there's so many medicinal properties to spices. And definitely start using them in your cooking if you're not already doing that. Or try to make some of these teas if you are looking to kindle your agni, or start making some of these hemas if you have a lot of heartburn and hyperacidity. I hope you found this video helpful. Again, I just wanted to show you my book. Last week I went through this. This is something about turmeric. So like this, I have a lot of these colorful pictures of spices. We've explained their qualities, their properties. We've also talked about if they're an anti-diabetic or anti-diuretic, you know, all of those things. And we've also given some home remedies that you can use, make some of these teas and fantas. We also have recipes for the teas at the back of the book. So definitely check out that book on Amazon if you want to learn more about spices and start using them as medicine. Okay, and hopefully this week you can practice paying attention to the spices and see why you're using them, how you're using them, see if there are traditional recipes that you're using, and see if it makes sense about the cooling and the heating. And I also shared this video last week, and I will do that again today. I made one for the Kidney Foundation talking about spices and how to make your own spice blends, especially if you're on a low sodium diet. So try this week, and we'll see you again next week. Have a wonderful week ahead. Hello everyone, thank you for joining me. Hope you enjoyed today's video. If you liked it, please subscribe, share, and listen to your body, observe your mind, and help yourself. Have a wonderful week ahead.